Hi, my name is Barb Nangle. I'm the founder of Higher Power Coaching and Consulting. I want to welcome you to my podcast, Fragmented to Whole, Life Lessons from 12-Step Recovery.
This is episode 62, Get To versus Have To. I found myself making this distinction once again in an outreach call the other day, and the distinction was between what we get to do versus what we have to do. What I mean is that we learn to frame things in terms of being a privilege as opposed to being a burden. In recovery, as with any personal growth process, a large part of the work is changing our perspectives. This is just another example of a way in which we change our perspective. So here are some examples of what I'm talking about. I've heard people say, I have to take responsibility now. And what I say to that is, no, you get to take responsibility now. That's what it means to be a mature adult, taking responsibility for your own life and your own actions and leaving everybody else's life and actions up to them. Another is, I get to have my own identity. I don't have to create my own identity. I get to have my own identity. And one of the ways we do that is keeping the focus on ourselves and keeping our nose out of other people's business and differentiating from our families. You don't have to keep the focus on yourself. You get to keep the focus on yourself. And let me tell you something, friends, when you start keeping the focus on yourself, you're not going to believe the amount of energy that becomes available to you when you focus on yourself and you leave everybody else's business to them. You don't have to differentiate from your family. You get to differentiate from your family. You don't have to form your own identity. You get to form your own identity. I have a sponsee who's working on the amends process right now, and this came up in that conversation as well. Here's how it went. I have to make amends for XYZ. And I was like, wait, actually, you get to make amends. What this means is that we have sometimes done some pretty shitty things in our lives. And this 12-step program of recovery gives us a way of literally making up for that. We get to clean that shit off of our soul. We get to make amends. And what do we get from making amends? We get to be happy, joyous, and free. We get to no longer be burdened by the weight of those deeds that maybe you don't even know that you're carrying. And while I'm talking about this, I want to share an example from my own amends process. It's relevant here. I had a couple of people from my teen years that I needed to make amends to, and I know someone who is a private investigator, and he volunteered to find them for me because I couldn't. And he said, one caveat, if they don't want to hear from you, you have to honor that. And I said, okay, if they don't want to hear from me directly, perhaps they will allow me to give you a letter that you can pass on to them. So he got back to me about a week later. He'd found both of them. One of them gave him their phone number so that I could call, and the other one was willing to take a letter through him. So I gave him the amends letter on one day, and the next day I called the person on the phone to make the amends. I ended up getting her voicemail. I left my message of amends, and when I hung up the phone, I started fucking sobbing. I had absolutely no idea that was coming. I had no idea that was even inside of me. It was such an incredible release. The reason I was sobbing was because of an enormous amount of gratitude that it was possible for me to make up for what I had done, to acknowledge and to apologize to another human being for what I had done. And I was also sobbing because of the enormous amount of freedom that I felt, the weight that was lifted off of me. My friends, we don't have to make amends. We get to make amends. We don't have to live clean and sober. We get to live clean and sober. And that's because we've cleaned up our lives in such a way that we don't need to escape from our lives anymore. That's why we weren't living clean and sober in the first place. Yes, we're addicts, but we also lived the kinds of lives that we couldn't face, and we needed to numb ourselves. Now we no longer need to numb ourselves and escape our lives. And that leads me to the last thing that I want to say about have to versus get to. A recovery friend said, okay, so now I have to love myself. She was talking about it as if it was a strategy, like a task she could check off her to-do list. If I love myself, then I'll get better. I said, no, actually, you get to love yourself. And the point of loving yourself is to love yourself. That's the point. It's not to get something. It's not to get better. It's to love yourself. So friends, these are privileges, not burdens. You get to have your own identity. You get to focus on yourself in the here and now. You get to take responsibility for your life and keep your nose out of other people's business. You get to make amends. You get to live clean and sober. And you get to love yourself. So go out there and enjoy the privilege of loving yourself. That's it for today. If you like what you've heard here, then you just might be interested in private coaching with me. If that sounds like you, head on over to my website, which is higherpowercoachingandconsulting.com, and click on the contact menu. I'd be happy to schedule a consultation with you to help you make lasting changes in your life, like I've made deep, lasting changes in my life. My ideal client is someone who is ripe for change, but I'll coach anyone who wants to be happy, joyous, and free. So if that's you, shoot me an email. I'd love to hear from you. Thanks for listening. Be sure to like and subscribe so you can be sure to get future episodes of my podcast. Thanks again.